This is
Swamp Rap Rap Dude.
All right, Swamp Rats, get your waders on. We're going trout fishing.
Ow, boy.
That's a wrap. That's season four right there.
Oh, folks, howdy. We're going to do some trout fishing today. And, I'm pumped. Haven't been here for 2 years, but it was the best time of my life when I went, so we're going to capture this time on film. All right? We're not in Rudolph today, but it's damn close up to my standards here. I'm not saying anything about that, but we'll see you out on the stream, all right?
Swamprat Outdoors presents trout fishing with special guest Kevin.
T-Baby, mine and Ginger's old middle school friend, no other than T-Baby.
We usually don't bring too many people on the Swamprat show here, but when we came to trout fishing, me and Rabid didn't know much how to go about doing this.
Am I doing this right, T?
Called up one of our old friends from middle school. T-Baby took the challenge, and I think it turned out real great.
Where's your line? I think you have better chance.
Cast it as bait just about everywhere except the water.
Rookie.
We're just nailing him out of this hole. Oh, Ginger, let's go. Get your game face on. Stay out of the grass.
I don't know if he thought there were fish up in the trees, and I don't know what he was thinking, but man, that was really getting on mine and T-Baby's nerves.
Ginger got snagged again. Rabbit's getting mad because he seems to hit the trees more in the water lately. Well, if you look at him, he's climbing the tree right now, trying to get his spinner out.
Just got my spinner. Now my pole's floating away. This whole tree is rotten. I'm gonna say that much. Not very fond of heights either. Don't feel like going in the drink today. Just been getting a lot of snags, but I ain't skunked. I mean, I got two fish on today. I'm just gonna try to get down here safely. Go get my pole that's probably halfway down the creek already. I mean, T-Baby. T-Baby, you up there, son? How you doing? How you doing up there? He's changing lures, son.
Ginger, let's go. Come on.
Hold on.
So, I mean, I'm running on no sleep. Really would like to get some fish on film. And here Ginger is. He's snagged in every goddamn tree that you see on the stream, and after a while, me and T-Baby were just laughing at it. Dang, that kid needs a practice. I'm gonna take him outside here in a bit and practice his casting skills. It's just pathetic.
Oh, it's a rock. We don't like them kind around here.
Hey, Luki, or Ginger. Come on. Ginger's back there, stuck in a tree, as usual.
Oh, sorry, man. I caught T-Baby.
When me and Rabbit went down there, we ain't used to the elevation change, the different things we saw, the mountains.
Wow! Look at all the scenery, folks. Look at all them hills. We don't have that in Rudolph, I'll tell you what. Ah! My ears just popped. All this elevation here. How do you equalize your ears?
But when I got down there and saw the mountains, I had to equalize so your ears don't pop.
A lot of different
people around this area are definitely not in Rudolph. I hear something coming right now. What was that? Do you know what was that, Rabbit?
You know, it's like a time travel. Way back in the 1800s, I mean, you see horse and buggy just fly by. I don't even know what it was.
Ginger, when I was telling him about this leading up to it, trying to get pumped about the trip, he was having nightmares about it, just thinking about leaving Rudolph, because we've only been outside of Rudolph about never. This is our first time being outside of Rudolph. So it's crazy, but well worth it. Well worth it, I'll tell you that much.
That's T Baby 2, Swamp Rat 0.
Oh, there one. Nice fish. Oh, look at this one. Nice fish. Oh, look at that fish. Wow. It's a pretty nice fish. Biggest one of the day. What do you think of that, T?
That was a good job.
Nice. Thanks. Hey, thanks for coming here. That's wow. Nice fish. There's one. I got one too.
There he is.
Whoa.
Look at that.
Double.
Folks, just hooked into a double here. Looks like mine's a little bigger than the guide's over here, T-Babies. But nice fish.
Yeah, she's a little small.
Oh, let's see a comparison,
they're
huh?
They're so fun.
Huh. There's one. Nice fish. Nice fish. We're gonna get him up here. Whoa, look at him jump.
Got a lot of spots on her. Beautiful trout. Another brown trout, he hit really hard right by my feet. Scared me. You can see the little flash chrome on him, looks pretty cool.
Nice fish. Looks like guide's living up to her name and catching some good fish here for us on Swamp Rat Outdoors.
Got a big one, folks. Fighting pretty hard. Here she comes. Yeah, she's pretty big. Palm male and a cut bank.
Howdy folks, Ginger here. We just got done walking off. Probably what would you say there, T-Babes?
Three quarter mile
of a stream. We caught probably 36 trout. Brown trout. They're pretty
one brook.
My mind is blown right now, folks. We're sitting here in God's country, we're just gonna call that.
So Ginger kept referring to this as God's country, and I mean, it was a beautiful place.
We're in God's country, welcome.
We're next to a couple trout streams right here, and people are waving all over, just friendly as heck. I mean, just amazing, look at that guy. That nice girl.
Just another small town, lots of friendly people. Everybody drove by, they waved back.
People zooming right up and down this highway, they're just waving.
Look when Junior was getting just extremely loopy and out of it, as if he's not already.
I mean, happy, just wildlife, but I just, supposedly Devil's Lake, camping school, jeepers, beach, cripes, barracks,
nothing like this out here.
I'll tell you what, but,
just cut through a little mountain pass, and he thought there was a stream up on top with magical 30-inch trout.
They had to climb the ropes, you know, and at mountains. I tell you what, we swamp rats, we don't need ropes, I tell you what. We're just climbing up there in the stream right on top, a little pool. But all right.
He was gonna climb up there and catch it. Got climbed all the way up to the top, and me and T-Baby are just shaking our head like, come on, man, we gotta get fishing.
I don't have a rope. Shut the heck up. Rev, you're gonna make me die. Dude, I'm higher than a kite.
Here we go!
Ginger, let's go, come on.
Hold on, I'm tying myself in here.
God. Let's go. Take a fish, stay out fishing. Ginger.
I guess he got a glimpse of the stream up at top and he got so excited he just jumped all the way down.
Ginger, let's go. Got fish to catch. Take her easy there. Don't break your ankle. Come on. Oh, there you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Oh. Oh, he ran your rod.
Broke. $100 fishing pole. Dumb thing by Ginger.
He ain't got no brain.
All right, T-Baby's already down there. We're gonna get the spinner in the water and see what we can do with these trout. First trout of the day. Oh, look at that. Did you see that? Wow, that's awesome.
Nice brown trout.
I got Ginger back there stuck in the tree while I'm catching the fish.
Folks, right now we're looking at a nice pool for trout, but Rabid fell down over there in that nettle stinging of nettle. But here we go for first cast in this nice pool. How come I always miss my bait?
Hey, Pete.
Oh, there's one, folks. Nice, 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 nice. Look at them. That's a nice, what is that, Taylor? T-Babe, brown trout. folks, we don't have this elevation in Rudolph, I'll tell you that much. Just different from here. Not very pretty women out here, but the scenery is good. I'll tell you what, we're gonna go down to the stream here. Folks, just some beautiful scenery around here. Good day of fishing. Oh, just missed him. That was a nice fish. Oh, second one missed. I don't know what I'm doing. They're reeling too fast or what? Oh, you see that one follow my lure right up? Almost had a double. Oh, there's one.
Whoa, Ginger, this is a good spot, ain't it?
Told you there's lots of trout in this hole.
You're darn right. First double on this creek, and I'm sure there's more to come in this hole. Let's let them go and keep casting.
Biggest trout of the day.
All right, folks. Our cameraman right here, he's completely stuck in the mud. And we got our guide, T-Baby. He's coming to save us.
I need help getting out of here. No, help me
out. Oh, T-Baby looks like he's gonna fish. Oh, he's gonna help. Whoa, we almost took a digger. All right, we're good. I'm gonna pull a trout out of here, watch. Fish. There we go, folks, told ya. What is that, chub? We don't want them around. Do they bite? My prediction was right. Pull the fish out of a hole like I said I was gonna. But it's not really much of a fish, it's a chub. It's pretty much worthless. Bottom feeders. So we're gonna let them go. Big. Oh, that's a nice trout right there, folks. Nice. 16, 17 incher right in there. There he is. Oh, a chub. Pulls him out of the water.
Look at him, oh my God. Look at him. You see them all?
Oh my God. They're like bats, except in the water. What? Ow! Hit me. Yeah.
Help me out here. I'm struggling.
All right.
Hey, Junior.
Rabid ended up getting caught in some quick mud, we call it.
It's like quicksand, but it's even worse. It's quick mud. And...
ah!
Hey!
Hold on, dude. One more cast. No, seriously, I got a trout on. Oh, oh, hey. God! Right there. One more cast and I got you. One more. One more cast, folks, and I'll get him. Don't worry about Rabid. Oh, not that one. That one don't count. Seriously, hold on. Hey, the more you struggle, the more you sink, all right? Haven't you learned that on Scooby-Doo, right, folks?
Not that one.
Jake, watch your head. Stop throwing stuff. Rabs.
You gotta come close here. You can't just pull straight out. You gotta pull me up.
I can't pull him up. I'm gonna sink down then.
We need a, like, a shovel.
Shovel, folks.
I was trying to get a different angle on the stream of T-Baby and Ginger casting out. Before you know it, I'm all the way up to my hip in mud, and I cannot move. I was jumping up and down, side to side, front and back, back and forth, and could not budge one single bit.
There, just pull up on it with my foot side. All right, now yeah, I get my other one.
Show me up here. Oh, jeez.
Oh, this one's getting stuck on
there.
Pull that one up.
Oh.
Alright, get this one down. He broke his leg. He shot his leg though.
Oh my god. Here, let's do a mud shot on the camera.
No. And then I'm gonna get into the creek.
You gotta roll this way and then you just go down there.
Okay. Help me roll.
Come on, let's go. Dude, you can roll by yourself for crying out loud. It's not Boy Scouts. Oh God, now I'm stuck.
After he pulled me out, he got stuck.
Dude, I'm gonna pull my freaking hip out of my socket.
Ah. Hey, you need help?
No.
Just a horrible day when it came to that stuff, but luckily, we hooked into a lot of fish.
Folks, I'm gonna try this little hole right here, kind of by some overhang. They usually hang in there. That's where we've been catching most of them, right in these edges of these deep holes, right along the bank. There's one, folks. Nice one. Nice fish. This is a big one. Nice fish. Whoo! Wow, look at that one. That's a big trout.
Nice out, Ginger.
Thank you. Wow, I just cast under this tree, just like I said. Pull up a nice 17 brown trout, folks. Just a beautiful day out here. Couldn't ask for better. I'd like to thank our guide, T-Baby, for bringing us here. Just a beautiful spot, landscape. And I mean, the Lord, baby Jesus, has provided us with something magnificent, these trout in this stream, and we're gonna catch them. So see what we got. There's one. That's what I'm talking about right there. Snap my line. Looks like we're gonna call her a day. I mean, there's miles and miles of trout streams, as we say. But I'm gonna end her at that. We'll see you next time. Behind the camera again is Rabs. I'm Ginger, and we got our new guide with us, T-Babes. He did a hell of a job today. We'll see you next time. Thanks.
This is
Swamp Rat.